Hi everyone, and welcome to this video. Today, I'll show you how to make the most out of Meta when it comes to saving images for a poster. Let's assume I'd like to make a poster of this car model here. For more details on how to bring your model at this stage, with rendering materials applied to it and settings optimized before taking an image, check out the video How to Take Good Snapshots for Reports and Presentations found in the same playlist. In order to create an impressive poster, you could make use of the ability to incorporate your model into a surrounding environment of an image of your choice. By default, Meta uses environment mapping when switching to render mode OpenGL. This means that the surrounding environment of an HDR image is reflected on the rendering materials. There's a series of HDR images available in your config folder upon installation. You can always choose any other HDR image saved in a directory instead. For now, I'll choose the parking lot and press open. By enabling Draw Environment, you can see the HDR image used at the time. There's also a series of settings available which you can adjust in order to achieve best integration of the model into the surrounding environment. Firstly, I'll choose the up axis accordingly so that the model is positioned in the right way in the picture. In this case, I'll choose Z. Then, I can rotate the HDR image around its vertical axis so that the model is best integrated inside the HDR image environment. In this case, I'll rotate it so that the car is parallel with the parking spaces. I can also adjust the size of the HDR image so that it best suits the model. Then, there's the option to add a virtual floor so that the model looks more natural in the picture. If needed, I can also apply a vertical offset to the virtual floor, bearing in mind the units of the model. And now this is a very impressive picture that can be printed in a poster. Now, for a bit of fine-tuning, you can use the option Explode to move the model around a little bit. So you can do so from the models list here. If you right-click on the model and choose Explode, and in this case X-axis, and I can drag it a little bit to the back. Lastly, since version 19.1, ambient occlusion has been introduced, so you can have real-time shadows in your model. If you right-click on the lighting button here, the lighting settings open, and you see a new tab introduced, which is called Shadows. Now, if you enable ambient occlusion from here, you can see that shadows are applied in your model. By changing this value, you increase the area where shadows have effect. Keep in mind that this value is in millimeters, so if your model is in another unit system, you need to apply it, and you can do so through the models list. If you click on Apply Unit System and choose your unit system accordingly, then Meta will calculate the shadows correctly. And now it's time to save our poster. I'll do so by using the Save Image button up here. By clicking on this icon, I can set the image parameters I need. I'll start by choosing the size, which in this case is going to be A0 for a poster. By activating the Preview button, I see how my image is going to look like. I'll change the orientation to Landscape, and I'll close the Image Parameters window. Then, I'll choose the directory where I'd like my images to be saved. I have selected a directory on my desktop. Next, I'll set the file type of my preference, I'm choosing PNG, and finally the naming convention I'd like to use. I prefer the date custom name sequence so that the date is visible on my image name. I'll type a prefix for my images, say poster, and you can see how the name looks like in the preview here. By setting start number to 1 and sequence digits to 2, my image will be named today's date, poster, and 01. At last, I'm ready to press the button and my poster is saved in my output directory. One last tip regarding posters. If by any chance you don't wish to use the HDR image background but prefer to use the picture in another context, don't forget to set the background to transparent from the image parameters here, as long as the file type is PNG. This way, you can paste your image in any picture you like. Thanks for watching!